Hello and welcome back to Learn Linux TV. In today's video, I'm going to show you the process of installing Debian on your computer. This is going to be a full installation. It's going to be the only operating system on the hard drive in this example. And specifically, I'm going to show you the process with the Netinstall installer. And the Netinstall version of Debian's installer is my preferred way to install Debian. Sure, there's going to be quite a few more prompts during the process, however, you get the most control. And the prompts might be intimidating due to the fact that there's quite a few of them, but it's not all that hard. I'm going to show you the entire process in today's video. Now, before we get into the topic at hand today, I need to take a moment to mention the sponsor for today's video, Akamai Connected Cloud. If you're looking for a cloud provider that's affordable, flexible, and reliable, then look no further than Akamai Connected Cloud. With Akamai's cloud platform, you can spin up Linux servers quickly, and the platform contains all the features you'll need to deploy full-featured solutions. And using the marketplace, you could easily deploy applications such as Nextcloud, RocketChat, Mastodon, WordPress, Pi-hole, Plex, Jenkins, and many more. In fact, there's over 100 applications available in the marketplace. If you want to set up a custom Linux instance, you could do that too. All the popular Linux distributions are available on the platform, including, but not limited to, Debian, CentOS, Fedora, Ubuntu, and many others. In fact, even Arch Linux is available. So check out Akamai Connected Cloud with the URL that you see on the screen right now, which will do two things. First, it'll help support this channel, which I'll really appreciate, and it'll also get you $100 in starter credit to check out the platform. And thank you yet again to Akamai for sponsoring this video. Thanks again to Akamai for sponsoring today's video. I really appreciate it. Now, with all of that out of the way, let's install Debian. As soon as you start your computer or server from the Netinstall image, this is the very first screen that you'll see right here. And as you can see, we have a few different options. We have graphical install, we have normal install, we have some advanced options. We have a dark contrast mode for those of you that might need that. And we even have an option with synthesized speech as well. Now, for whatever reason, the Debian installer is still at 800 by 600 when it comes to resolution, so it's possible that it might look a little blurry, but other than that, it should be the exact same thing on your end. Now, what I'm going to do is choose the normal install option, not the graphical install. It doesn't really matter which of those you choose, the prompts will be exactly the same. In fact, the graphical install is probably better because with that option, you'll have access to use your mouse. Due to the 800 by 600 resolution and the fact that things will look a little bit blurry, I'm going to choose the install option right here just for that purpose. I think it might look better in the screen recording, but the process is the exact same with either option. Anyway, I'll press enter and let's get the process started. Now, what I'm going to do is go through the various options here one at a time. And the first one here is going to give us an opportunity to choose the language for the installation process. I'm going to choose English on my end, but if your native language is something else, feel free to customize that here. Anyway, I'll press enter. And next, it's asking us to choose the location. So on my end, I'm going to choose United States, so I'll press enter right there. That's the default in my case anyway. Next, we choose the type of keyboard that we have. Mine is just a standard American English keyboard, so I'll just choose that one. You could always use the up and down arrows to select something else if you'd like. And now that the installer has fully loaded, it's asking us to configure the network. On my end, I have an option for two different network interfaces, but depending on your computer or server, you may have only one option here, or you may even have more. What you want to do here is choose the primary network interface that you plan on using. The first one here, starting with ENP, that's going to refer to my wired network interface. We even see it listed here as a gigabit network connection. Now the second one has to do with wireless because the computer that I'm installing this on has a Wi-Fi adapter, specifically the 9260 from Intel. Now I'm not going to choose that one because wireless is almost always going to be slower than wired, so I'll choose the first option here. Just choose whatever makes the most sense for you. Anyway, I'll choose that and press enter. And now it's asking me to name this particular computer. And it's already pre-selected footage PC as the hostname, and the reason why it knows that is because it got that information through DNS. On my router, I have a static lease for this computer, so that way it'll always get the same IP address. And it also includes a DNS entry as well, which is where the hostname comes from. On your end, just name your computer or server, whatever you'd like. I'm going to leave the default here, but keep in mind that whatever you name your computer, that's going to show up on your network if you share files between your machines. Anyway, I'll press enter, and then it's going to ask for the domain name as well, which might be blank for you. I do have a domain here, and it's automatically detected that. What you could do here is type your domain if you have one, but if you don't, you could simply just erase everything here and leave it blank. Anyway, I'll press enter. And the next thing that the installer is asking us to do is set the password for the root user. Now, something to know about this is that if you bypass this, meaning you press enter without typing a password, then the root account will be disabled. If you do that, then you'll have access to sudo as the main user account that you create after this. But anyway, the first thing you should do is make a decision as far as whether or not you want the root account to be enabled in the first place. If you do want it enabled, type the desired root password right here. And if you don't want that enabled, then, well, leave it blank. Now, on my end, I will create a password for the root user. And then I'll verify it. And now the root account has been configured, and at this point, it's asking us to set a name for the new user account that we should be using instead of the root account, our admin user, if you will. So what you could do is type your name right here if you'd like. You could type your full name as it's asking for, or you could just simply type your first name if you want. It really doesn't matter. I'm just going to use my first name here in lowercase. And after I press enter, it's asking me for the actual username of my account, which is going to default to whatever you typed in the name field here. As you can see, I have J here for the username by default. That's what I typed for the full name, so I'll press enter for that. So I'm sorry to interrupt my own video, but did you know that there's a dedicated community page set up for this channel? Well, there is. You could go to community.learnlinux.tv and chat with other Linux fans. All you have to do is go to that page and sign up for an account, and I'll approve your account within a couple of days. You know, I'm always making content for you guys, so I might be glued to the camera, but if you sign up for an account, I'll approve your account within a few days, and then you could chat with us. So come on in and hang out with other Learn Linux TV fans. I would really appreciate that. And next, it's asking us to set a password for that user. So I'll set that now and verify it. Now here it's asking us to choose our time zone. So depending on your location settings earlier, you might have different options here. My time zone is Eastern, so I'm going to select that. It's already selected anyway, so I'll press enter. And now it's giving us an option to set up the hard drive. Now in this tutorial, like I mentioned earlier, I am going to be taking over the entire hard disk and replacing it with Debian 12. So for that, we could use the guided options here. For example, use entire disk, which is the one that I'm going to go with. That does exactly what I mentioned. It uses the entire disk. We can also set up LVM, which I highly recommend if you are setting this up on a server. The only reason why I'm not doing that is because this is just a demo installation anyway. You could also choose to have your hard drive encrypted if you need that extra security. If you plan on storing company confidential things on your hard drive, then you might want to go with this option. Now, I'm not going to cover the manual partitioning in this video, but what I will do is use the entire disk, so I'll choose this option right here. And next, it's asking me to choose which hard drive I want to install Debian onto. So what you'll do is just choose whatever hard drive that happens to be if you have more than one. If you only have one hard drive, then you don't really have much of a choice anyway, do you? Anyway, I'll just choose my NVMe storage right here for my Debian installation, and that's what's selected. Now, the drive underneath it is a USB disk. That's the drive that I've installed the Debian installer image onto, so it does show the USB flash drive that you have inserted if you do have one inserted. Anyway, my hard drive is the first option, so I'll choose that. Next, we have a few different selections on how we want that to be partitioned. The default here is to have all files in one partition. If you want to have your home directory, for example, on its own partition, you might want to choose this option. And I think it's not a bad direction to go. It really doesn't matter which one you choose here. The end result will be mostly the same. This has to do with partitioning. I'm going to go ahead and choose this option here to set up a separate home partition for myself, and I'll press enter. Now, before we continue, what it's going to do is give us an overview of the changes that are going to be made to our hard disk. And here it's showing me my NVMe hard drive as well as the flash drive. Notice under SSD, it has the letter F going down, and that stands for format. So it's going to be creating and formatting those partitions. Now the USB disk has nothing there for that field at all. It's not going to have any changes applied to it at all, which is exactly what I want. You basically just make sure that everything here looks okay to you, and once it does, you'll choose the option here, Finish Partitioning. So I'll choose that and press Enter. It's going to ask us yet again, are you sure? Because it's planning on wiping out everything. And I hope if you do have files on your computer, you've already backed them up, because once we choose the option yes right here, well, there's no turning back. I'm ready to go, so I'll press Enter. And now it's installing the base system. There's going to be a number of additional prompts that'll come up, so I'll just let this finish. Now here it's asking us to configure the package manager, specifically to choose a country for our preferred mirror. You'll want to choose whatever country you reside in, because that's where it's going to be grabbing its software from. Somewhere local is always better than somewhere further away, unless there's some sort of restrictions in your country or something like that. But anyway, I'll just choose United States because that's where I am. And then it asks you to choose the Debian mirror that you want to go along with. I recommend you just choose the first option. That's almost, if not always, a great option. If you have a specific reason to want to choose something else, you could go ahead and do that. But if you don't have a reason, well, choose the first option, which is what I'll do. So I'll press Enter. Next, it's asking us for information regarding our proxy. Now, for many of you, you probably won't have one. If you do have one, well, you've probably had to contend with this before, in which case you might know what to put here. If you don't know what to add for your proxy information here, if you do have a proxy, well, your local network administrator, if that's not you, will have that answer. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, then you don't have a proxy, so just press Enter. Now, at this point, we're going to see a prompt like this one that's going to ask us if we'd like to enter into a popularity contest. Now, Debian is quite popular, so why would it need more popularity? Well, this has nothing to do with that. This just helps Debian developers understand which packages are commonly installed. If you want to give them that information, then you could choose yes for that prompt. But I'm going to choose no. This is just a test installation anyway. So I'll leave it at the default of no and press Enter. And here we have a very important selection to make. If we want a desktop environment, which one do we want? If we don't want any desktop environment, for example, if we're setting up a server, then what we'll do is deselect everything. If we're setting up a server and we'd rather not have a desktop environment, then what we could do is deselect the first two options. And to do that, you'll simply press space on your keyboard with an option selected, and that will add or remove an asterisk for that selection. If you want something, you leave the asterisk here. If you don't, you take it away. Now, I'm going to be using this installation for more Debian footage that I plan on capturing, so I do want a desktop environment. And on your end, if you want a different desktop environment, for example, if you prefer not to have GNOME, you could deselect that and choose something else. Maybe you want GNOME Flashback. Perhaps you want KDE Plasma. That's a good choice. Cinnamon is a good one as well. Or if you want to, just choose all of them. If you don't know which one you should choose, well, I have a video that goes over the basic desktop environments and the differences between them. I'll leave a card for that video right about here. Now, what I'm going to do is just leave it at the default. I'm going to choose the GNOME desktop environment. And I'm also going to choose SSH server as well. And this gives me access to use SSH to remotely manage this particular installation. If you're setting up a server, then you almost always want this. If you're setting up a desktop or a laptop, you probably don't, unless you run into a situation where you commonly leave your laptop in another room, and rather than walking over to it, you could use SSH to manage it from your couch if you wanted to. I'll leave that up to you. I do plan on using SSH, so I will select that option. Next, we'll press Tab, which puts the selection on Continue. So that's what I'll choose. Let's continue the installation. Now, it's going to install, in my case, 1,405 packages. And that's fairly typical. If you're installing a desktop environment, there's quite a few components that get installed along with that desktop environment. Each one of these components are fairly small, so it's not going to take a ridiculous amount of hard drive space or anything like that. but it is going to take a little bit of time because it's going to download each of these packages and install them. So I'll let this continue, and then I'll be right back. And check it out! The installation is complete. So what I'll do is let it reboot, and then I'll be right back. And check it out! Right here, we have Debian 12 installed on my footage PC, and it's ready to go. I hope you enjoy your new Debian installation. Debian 12 is awesome, and I think you're going to love it. I loved it, as a matter of fact, and when I reviewed it, I called it the best Debian ever. If you haven't seen my review of Debian 12, well, I'll leave a card for that video right about here, and you can check out that video. There's all kinds of Debian coverage on my channel, so make sure you subscribe to Learn Linux TV for the latest in Linux, and I'll see you in the next video.